Hello everyone, this is Saurabh Kumar and today I am making a video for configuring Cisco ASF firewall. And basically I will be demonstrating firewall configuration in Packet Tracer. But one thing you can keep in your mind, that whatever command and process I am going to do here, it will remain same in your working environment firewall as well. So if you are planning to maybe implement firewall in your working environment, if you are planning to use firewall in your organization, you may go through this video, and here I will be showing you the basic configuration which will be helpful when you are maybe configuring firewall in your organization for the first time. So let me use Packet Tracer here because I will be demonstrating everything on a single interface. So it will be better way to use Packet Tracer here, which is again being provided by Cisco to do some kind of simulator work inside of it. So in this video, I will be first of all making a topology. So let me first make a topology here. So simply first I go to a firewall and I pick a firewall here. So let's say that this is your company firewall. Basically, your firewall will be obviously connected to either your router, or either it can be connected to any of the ISP router. So let's assume that this is nothing else but it is my ISP router. So maybe I give a name also here, and that is ISP router. Then this firewall, obviously now you're going to connect it with a switch. So you can have a switch here, and maybe then switch is connected to some of the computers. It can be one computer here and another computer maybe here. So this is maybe the topology we have. We know that to configure the ASF firewall in real environment, obviously you need one more computer here, and that computer you are going to actually connect with the console cable from your computer to the firewall console port, so that you will be getting a command line interface from this machine to the firewall. Now let me first of all connect all of them. So for connecting all of them, what I am going to actually do is, let me even add one more thing here, that is server. So I am going to add here a server, and that server I will be imagining like maybe this is my Google server or maybe DNS server, something like that. So this is my scenario going to be in this entire video series. So now the second thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make them all connected. So to connect them, first of all let me connect these computers with it. Then next thing I need to do is I need to connect again the this router with the server. For that I need a crossover, because router to computer we generally use crossover cable because they are similar type of device. And after them, now we need to connect this switch also with the firewall and with the router. So for that we can use the straight through cable. So here maybe I use, you can see that firewall is having Ethernet port, not fast Ethernet port. So I have to keep in my mind that which cable I'm using for which side. So maybe I use Ethernet 0/1 here, connecting to any port of the switch, and then Ethernet 0/0 I connect with the router here. So that is what my topology is. If I want to mention here, it is E0/0. And I will be using here the IP address, which should be the public IP address. Maybe my service provider has given me an IP address, so maybe it is IP is 50.1.1.2. I'm just taking an example here. And maybe the service provider router is having the IP address, that is first of all the port number. So let me verify which port number I have used to connect this cable. So it is F0/0. So here let me mention it is F0/0, and the IP address I'm using is maybe 50.1.1.1. Then another side here, I need to use any IP address. So before that, what is the interface I'm using? That is F0/1. So I mention here F0/1, and maybe my IP address I'm using here is 8.8.8.1, because I am planning to have this computer IP 8.8.8.8. I'm assuming that this is my DNS server of the Google. So that is the IP address I am planning to use. Now when we talk about this side, it can have any of the private IP address. So first of all, what is the port number here is E0/1, and the IP address maybe I am planning to use is 10.1.1.1. This is my private IP address. So this is what actually my plan is in this video. So we are now done with the assigning the IP address on the we have not assigned it internally, we have just decided what IP we are going to use in this topology. So now accordingly, let's do the next task, that is assigning IP address on ASA and ISP router. So let me start with the ASA itself. So I go to this machine, because it is connected to through the console cable to the firewall. So I can go to the desktop, I can go to the terminal, and here from I will be getting the command line interface of the ASA firewall. So you can see from here, now I can go to the enable. It require a password, so when I hit enter, there is no password by default. But one thing I would like to mention here, that whenever you are using a ASA firewall in your packet tracer, or maybe if you are even using in your real environment, it may have some basic pre-configuration also. So let me check, is it having any already some configuration inside of it? And when I check show running configuration, I can not see any information related to any interface, but one information what I can see is it has some setting related to the interface VLAN 1. I am not the one who has set this IP address. So what I have to do is, even if I scroll down more, you can see that by default DHCP server is enabled on the ASA firewall. That is the default setting actually. So first thing what I am going to do here is, I am going to remove those default setting. So first task I am going to do is, I am going to global configuration mode, and here I am going to type no, because I want to remove. What I want to remove is DHCPD a space whatever the address the DHCP was having. So what is the address it has, you can even copy from here if possible, and then you can paste it here. No DHCPD address, this information, and then hit enter. So this way we have first of all remove the DHCP from this particular ASA firewall. I can check also, so running configuration, hit enter, go next, and if you see here, now there is no any DHCP range configured on the firewall. So that is we have done. Let me even remove the IP address, or maybe rather than removing the IP address which is there right now, what we can do is, we can just set a new IP address, so automatically the previous one will be removed. So let me directly go to the global configuration mode, and then I go to interface VLAN space 1, and now I want to set the new IP address rather than having the previous one, which is 192.168. I am going to set here the new IP address, that is 10.1.1.1/255.0.0.0. So we have set a new IP address now on interface VLAN 1. If you want, you can put here no shutdown command, but that is not necessary. VLAN port is by default in no shutdown mode. Then the next task we are going to do actually here is, in our firewall, always our port works into two scenario, either inside or either outside. Inside is means your the interface which is connecting to your private network, and outside where your interface is connected to the public, means internet network. So here this interface VLAN 1, I want to use it for my local network, that you can see 10.1.1, I want to use for my local area network. So that's why I am going to say here is name if, and I give it name, that is inside. Then after setting the inside, you also need to set one more thing always on your firewall, that is the security label. So the next command is going to be security label, and here you are going to determine the number. So let me make here one clear information, that when we talk about security label, we can use any value between 1 to 100. So if you are using the value like Maybe if I say that security level, if you set 100, that is generally we set for inside, means security level is very low because it is my local area network. If you set 1, generally we set 1 for the outside, that means security level is one of the most high in condition, and then we can use any value, sorry, it will be 0, not 1. And if I use any value between 1 to 99, this value we generally use for DMZ network. Means any other device, any server or something, if you have connected in DMZ, maybe your web server or something, you can put that interface with the security label, any value between 1 to 99. So here, when we talk about this interface, actually it is our local area network, so I can use the security label, that is 100. So let me go back here and I set security level 100. Then I come out from here, exit, and after that, which port, physical port actually is connected here? So it is E0/1. So I go to interface E0/1 and I say that here switch port access, and I give the VLAN number. In which VLAN it's supposed to belong, so my VLAN number is 1. So whatever setting we did in VLAN number 1, it is affected to now this port, because this port now belong to VLAN number 1. Now what is the next? So next we are going to do here is, now we go to exit and we go to now interface VLAN number 2. We are going to now create a VLAN number 2 for this area. So for that VLAN 2, here also I need to set the IP address, so I set IP address, and what IP will be here, so it is 50.1.1.2.255.0.0.0, then no shutdown, sorry, and after that we are also going to set the same thing here, that is name if, and this time I am going to give the name, that is outside. Because it is outside, so what will be the security label? Security label is going to be 0. Then we also go to exit, and this is the port is E0/0. So I go to interface E0/0 and I put it into the switch port access VLAN number 2. Means this port is going to act inside the VLAN number 2, and VLAN number 2 in configuration is the one which we have set here. So this way we are done with setting the IP address as well as the security label for both of the VLAN on this firewall. Now the next task is remaining, and the task is going to be here, that is going to be setting the IP address on the router. So we go to CLI of it, say no, go to enable. After making it enable, we go to global configuration mode and we set the IP address here also. So we are having actually two interfaces there as well. One is F0/0, so interface F0/0. The IP address I want to use here is 50.1.1.1/255.0.0.0. Any mistake? Yes. Then no shutdown. Similar to that, we do the same interface F0/1, and the IP address I want to use here is 8.8.8.1/255.0.0.0. No shutdown. So this way we are done with this changes. So this way we have actually set the IP address on the router, and we did the same actually with the firewall. Now let me check the IP of this machine. So I go to desktop IP configuration and I set here IP address 8.8.8.1. That can be the default gateway, and that's it. So this way we are done with the setting the IP address on almost all of those devices. Now we are moving to next step. So we have made a topology, we have assigned IP address, we have set inside outside. Now we are going to configure DHCP and DNS on ASA so that these people who are connected with this interface, they should get the IP address automatically from this firewall. Right now if I check here, desktop IP configuration, I made it DHCP. It is requesting to IP, but it is not getting IP address. But let me keep them into DHCP mode. And then now we are going to set the DHCP server and the range as well as the DNS IP on the firewall. So for that, let me again go to this computer, because here from we are accessing that configuration or console of the firewall. So now what we are going to do here is we go to the global configuration mode, and here we are going to set DHCPD space address. And here we are going to define the range. So my range, I want maybe 10.1.1.10 up to 10.1.1.30. Maybe this is what I want to have a range, a space inside. So I have given a range of DHCP, that is starting from the value 10 up to the 30, and it depend on the number of computer you have in your network. Then the next one more thing I want to do here is DHCPD DNS, because I also need to mention the DNS IP address. I want to put here 8.8.8.8 space interface inside. So this is the second command I use to set the DNS IP on the DHCP server. So we have done configuring DHCP server and DNS IP on Cisco ASA. So if everything is going smoothly and okay, now we should test it from the computer, and you can see that it has got the IP 10, and right now it is getting the default gateway, that is 10.1.1.1, but it has not got the DNS. So now I just refresh it, and you can see it is getting now even the DNS. Same, let me check on this machine also. So here you can see all and everything is working fine, because now this machine is acting as a DHCP server, so it is providing the IP, subnet mask, default gateway as well as the DNS IP to my client machines. So we are done up to the step number 4. Now we are going to go for the step number 5, where we are going to configure default route on ASA. Because ASA is having only one route to reach to all the other network. This is only one network. So to reach to any other network, it has only one path. So we can configure here the default routing. So for that, again, we go to the terminal of it, and we are going to configure default routing here. So for that, the command is going to be root space outside a space the path, so that is going to be any IP address with any subnet mask. It's supposed to go to actually 50.1.1.1, because that's the IP of the router here. So that's why we are using that IP address. Hit enter, and that's how we are actually done with the fifth number part, configuring default route on ASA. Now we are going to move on the part number 6, means the step number 6. So for doing the step number 6, let us go to the router. On the router, we are going to configure OSPF, or it can be any routing protocol, any dynamic routing we need to just configure here. So I go to global configuration mode, and I can use maybe router OSPF with the any of the process ID. So maybe my process ID is 1, and then next will be the network, and what are the network directly connected with this router. So one is 50 network, one is 8 network. So I can set here network a space 50.0.0.0 a space what it else it require. So it require the wildcard bits, means 0.255.255.255, that's the wildcard mask, a space area and then area number. Same I need to do once again with the another network, and that network is 8. So I have configured now OSPF on the router. So this is how actually I am done with the step number 6 also. Now the next is remaining is 7th number. So we are going to create an object network and enable NAT on ASA. But before that, let me check one thing. Am I able to reach from here up to the DNS server? Let me test once again. Right now still you can see that it is going to be failed because my firewall is not allowing to pass any kind of packet from there. So what we are now going to do next is we are going to the 7 number step, that is create object network, and we are also going to enable NAT on the ASA. So for that we go to again terminal of this machine where from we are accessing the firewall. We are at the global configuration mode and the command is going to be object object a space network a space. You can give any name here. It is actually looking for a word which is specifying what kind of network you are making. So I can maybe give a name that is just LAN. So object network LAN, and then I need to define here the subnet, which subnet is belongs to that. So you can see from here my private network subnet is 10. So I'm going to use here 10.0.0.0 a space 255.0.0.0, that is the subnet mask. So this way we have defined the, we have created the object. Now the next task we are remaining with configuring the NAT. So to configure the NAT here, we are again going to look for what exactly the private IP and what exactly public IP you are going to translate. So simply, rather than saying that, I can configure maybe here by saying NAT a space here put question mark. You can even get the condition like you have to put inside the bracket what kind of NAT you want to have. So I'm going to put in the bracket inside comma outside bracket close a space dynamic a space interface. Means I have configured a NAT between inside and outside interface with the dynamic condition. Now this is how we are done with the step number 7, where we have configured the, we have created an object network as well as we have enabled a NAT on the ASA firewall. Now we can check with the communication. So once the NAT is configured, they suppose to start communicating. Let me test again. Okay. So now still we are not getting the any kind of reply. The reason behind it is we have not configured it the ACL. But before I configure ACL, I would like to start maybe the ping. So I go to here, I go to the command prompt and I say ping a space minus t a space 8.8.8.8. Are we getting any reply? So answer is no. Same I do from this computer also, command prompt, I say ping a space 8.8.8.8. Let me even add minus t here to get continue reply. So you can see that we are not getting any kind of reply, nor on this machine or neither on the another machine. Both of them we are getting request timeout. But as soon as we will be configuring the ACL, immediately the reply will start coming and our actually firewall will start working, will start serving to our network. So let it keep into the another side here, and then we go to maybe configure here ACL. So that is the 8th number of a step. To configure the ACL, first of all we go back to the global configuration mode, and here the command is going to be access list here. So here we are going to use access, and you may just put maybe even the this format. Then this is a bit different than configuring access list on the router. There we just directly set the number 1 or 2 or something for the static and extended type of a standard and extended type of access list. But here if you put question mark, it require actually identifier name, and that has to be a word, any name to this access list. So I can give any name to this access list. Maybe I want to give the name of this access list is office to internet, something like that. Whatever name you give, or just let me give a very small name, office to internet, OTI. It is not a command, it is just a name I am giving. So access list, suspect any name, a space, here you are going to type extended. Because if you put question mark, it will tell you what kind of format you are looking for. So I am looking for extended. And after that, we are going to give a permit to TCP, a space, any source, any destination. Then the same command you use, but this time for the protocol, that is ICMP also. ICMP. Any. So we have created an access list where one time we have defined that it is access list which is permitting TCP from any source to any destination. Then another we have configured where we are saying permit ICMP to any source to any destination. And after that, the last but not least, we are going to run one more command here. That command is access group. Access group, a space, the same name which you have given, which you have used earlier. So it is going to be OTI, a space. You are going to say interface. You can put even question mark also to check in or out. So you can basically define directly in or out also. So I just say maybe outside. So this way we are actually configuring the group, and once, as soon as I will hit enter, this access list will start working, and once it start working, we are going to get the reply. So maybe my one is here which was not getting any reply, and then another one is here which was not getting reply. Let me put in a same frame. And then here, I am going to get ready with running and hitting this command. So now let me hit enter here. Okay, let me put question mark. Okay, so it is going to be interface. And that is going to be outside. So this command is basically going to activate my SEL, and where I have given the scenario, that is access group, and the group name is OTI. Oh sorry, I did a mistake here, which supposed to be actually in here, not out, because this is my in, which we want to transfer to the interface, and then it will be outside. So this will be the command, access group OTI, that is the group name or access list name, which is being working between the in to the interface out. So once, as soon as I'm going to hit enter here now, both of this machine will supposed to get a start replying from the DNS server. So let me hit enter here and just wait and watch for it. You can see that now both of the machine has started getting reply, and that's how now my firewall device has started working properly, and we have configured the firewall, and we are accessing the DNS server passing through the firewall. So this way we have configured the firewall already. My firewall is now allowing to go up to the DNS server. So any of this machine now has started getting the communication. So we can test by this way also successful. If we test for this machine also from here up to DNS server, the condition is successful. So now we are able to reach up to the DNS server or internet, whatever this side is, through the firewall, because now my firewall is configured. So we have followed all of this step to configure the firewall to reach our client machine up to the internet. Now only let me just go with the last step, that is verifying. So we can verify so many things on the firewall, and among them let me at least show you few of them. So for verifying, simply go to the privilege mode of the firewall, and there you may just run command something like so a space NAT. So it will show you the NAT, and it is saying that your NAT is working in this way, that it is translating from inside to the outside with the dynamic LAN interface. And here it is telling you also the how many translation till now it has done, as many number of packet will be passing through the firewall from this client side to the internet, that many number of translation hit will be. And because of the NAT, it is now working, it is communication is happening between the client up to the internet. One more maybe verification command I would like to tell you here is so a space xlet. When you run this one, it is also going to give you some detail like yes, xlet is right now in use, two in use, two most used, because we are having that scenario here. And it is also telling me that how it is, it has worked. So it is using the actually the port address translation, and it is converting your this particular IP address, which you remember this is 10.1.1.10, this is the IP of this machine, is being translated into 50.1.1.2 with the port number this one. And then for another machine 10.1.1.12 is being translated into this particular one. So this way you can verify also that yes, your firewall is working, the NAT is working, ACL is working, everything. You can even go to the CLI, you can run so running configuration to check all the configuration which you did. So here from you can see that on the VLAN 1 we set this IP address with the name if inside and security level 100. For VLAN 2 we have done this changes, then we have created a object network LAN, then we have created the default routing on it, then we created the access list with the name of OTI for both of this protocol, then at the end we created the access group which is working for inside to the outside. And that's how my firewall is working now and our connection is ready. We have also configured the DHCP server, which is helping us to provide the IP address to any of the clients. So if now any new machine I also bring here, I just put it here and I connect, and I go to this machine, desktop IP configuration, I make it DHCP. It may take some time because our switch is working still into the STP. So as soon as this STP time will be finished, when the link will become up, this machine will be getting an IP address from the DHCP server. And once it gets the IP address, then subnet mask, gateway, as well as the DNS IP address, it will be also able to communicate. So let me just do it once again. Now it is going to send a request, and you can see it has received IP 11, DNS IP 888. And if I check the communication from this new machine up to the internet, connection is very, very successful. So this way, if I add even 100 computer or as many number of computer I add in my company, they all will have the access to the internet through the firewall. Only the thing is, if your IP address range is small, you have to increase if you increase the number of computer. So I hope this video has been informative for you all, and I would like to thank you for watching.